for this webinar. Be like a water, have a smile, across obstacles to have a power of success. So it's my immense pleasure to welcome you all for this webinar on behalf of Aircrew Aviation Private Limited. And success is not final. Failure is not fatal. It's a courage to continue that counts. So I'd like to welcome our chief guest, Dr. Pallavi Doshi Kapurai, on the welcome of Aircrew Aviation Private Limited. And I have to like to tell about something interesting about our chief guest. Dr. Pallavi Kapurai was the author, consulting services, and have worked in MBIT and over 16 years of experience she had. And Dr. Pallavi has authorized a book called Customer Relationship Management, which was published in the year of 2017. And he has been presently working as a prestigious Institute of Management and a renowned B-School Central of India at the Faculty Department of Marketing. So we have welcomed you all. And I have been given a topic that she has been present to us, the topic of navigating customer experience. I would like to welcome the ma'am of this session. Over to you, ma'am. We are welcome you.
Thank you so much, Raja Rajeshwari. I must compliment you for your name. It's a lovely, beautiful name.
Thank you so much.
Very good afternoon to everyone present here. And I would like to thank Captain Shekhar Gupta as well for this wonderful series of webinars which you have been conceptualizing for the young budding professionals. So thoughtful of you, and I would like to thank you for this invite and this opportunity for me to interact with these young budding professionals. Now, when we were talking about, Captain Shekhar were brainstorming on the theme of this webinar, both of us had a consensus on customer experience, as we thought that customer experience is something that you as young professionals, you have to constantly deal with this day in and day out. So this is something very apt we could really think of. And personally, if I talk about my own self, I'm really passionate about customer experience. I'm fascinated with customer experience. I don't know where did it start from, but I would like to mention here that the book which I authored on customer relationship management has its very root in this fascination of customer experience. I guess it has been over years that I have accumulated as a customer of various brands at various points of time. My experience as a customer that helped me to kind of come up with that book and develop this kind of obsession about customer experience. So here we are all are on this platform talking about how to navigate through customer experience. Raja Rajeshwari, do I have the rights to share the screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So I don't have a very formal presentation. Still, I would like to take you through a quick concept on an insight into customer experience. Is my screen visible?
Yes, ma'am, it's visible.
Perfect. So the theme, as I said, would be navigating through customer experience. Now, I would like to start with a very famous quote, which I came across in one of the reports of Gartner, which reads that customer experience is the new competitive battlefield, and it's where the business is won or lost. Now, some people find it an exaggeration. But personally, if I talk about my own self, I feel this is very true. How many of you do agree with me? You can just mention a yes or no in the chat box. Okay. So, now we often hear and toss around the term customer experience, but what exactly does it mean? As a customer, one has a set of experiences, and as a brand, one believes in delivering those experiences, right? So customer experience can include a lot of elements, but it really boils down to one crucial element, and that crucial element is the perception of the customer, which the customer has about your brand. And that is based on the experiences and the delivery, what has been made to you, right? So with that in mind, managing customer perception is the most crucial thing a brand should be doing. Everything a brand does contributes to how customers perceive it. Therefore, to the overall customer experience, right? In fact, customer experience has become a crucial differentiator into today's hyper-competitive, hyper-connected global marketplace. And there's a tangible business value in managing the customer experience very effectively. Customer experience management can strengthen brand preferences through differentiated experiences. It leads to improving customer loyalty and create your brand advocates through valued and memorable customer interaction. It even boosts your revenue and incremental sales from existing customers and new sales from across the word of mouth. It also lowers down your cost by reducing the customer churn. So these are the certain advantages of having a great customer experience. So a brand has to focus all its efforts in delivering either a great customer experience or an exceptionally great customer experience. There is no room for a bad customer experience. Now we'll just look at from the perspective of customer life cycle journey. A customer goes through various stages in the life cycle. I'll just show you one of the slides. There's a time when a customer feels the need of a product or a service, and there is a time when the need is met by the marketer. So creating that awareness from the part of the marketer, then the customer gets nurtured as a prospect, a desire is generated in him, he goes for a purchase decision, that is customer acquisition. And the more important part arises, that is customer development, which is the crucial part of customer experience, wherein the support system leads to developing customer loyalty. And if the customer has that wow factor, he develops as a brand advocate. And thereafter, he leads to a new customer in your kitty, new customer.
Yeah, Shiva? Nay.
May I request everyone to kindly mute themselves? That will help us. Thank you so much. Okay, so when we saw the customer life cycle journey, for building your brand, you need to think from the customer's perspective, as I already told you. You have to understand and be concerned about the customer at every step of their journey, their life cycle. And to get a better understanding of the customer journey mapping, you need to have a clear idea about the stages of customer life cycle. Just like we saw, it's right from the time he feels the need of a product or a service, and then he has a solution for his product, for his need, and it goes on till the time he makes a purchase decision and extends his association with your brand as a true brand advocate. Throughout the customer life cycle journey, a brand could be good in one area or it may struggle in any other area, which could lead to an overall poor experience. Now consider what would happen if a company that hires passionate people and trains them to love the product. They will obviously shine and likely help the customers in the best possible way, and they'll create a great experience for the customer, leading to a strong perception of the brand in the minds of the customers. On the other hand, you just imagine a company which hires employees for its stores or for its call centers or wherever an employee is dealing with a customer. They were apathetic about the services and didn't really want to be there. What would happen? You would likely have poor customer interaction. And of course, that would lead to customers to perceive the brand doesn't care about them. So that's the place where the customer experience shapes up. It may be a good experience or a bad experience. Similarly, many other things contribute to the overall perception. It includes, it's not only the product or the services, but it's the overall package, overall experience, overall ambience, and everything, even the ease of navigating through a website, that also becomes a part of customer experience, right? So a brand should take time to make sure that every step of customer journey is strong and it creates a good perception and makes it more likely that customer will come back to you and even recommend your brand. Like I said, they need to be your brand advocates. But customer experience is a very fragile concept and can change with every interaction. Customer needs are dynamic. Customers, they've been pampered like anything by the brands. So it's up to the brand to keep on with that pampering. And each interaction should be such that it constantly maintains a strong customer experience. Now the customer experience, the concept of customer experience may sound idealistic or touchy-feely, but anyone who dismisses it as such is woefully out of touch. So a brand has no option but to focus on exceptionally delivering exceptionally great customer experiences. Now let's understand it from the point of view of various touch points and moments of truth a customer undergoes throughout his life cycle journey. As I mentioned, customer experience is extremely fragile and can change with each moment of truth. So it's crucial for a brand to constantly maintain the experience at all the touch points across all the moments of truth. Let's understand what these moments of truth are. The phrase moment of truth was coined long back. It was introduced by Richard Norman and actually popularized in the year 1987 by Jan Carlson. He was the CEO of Scandinavian Airlines. At that time, Carlson was responsible for helping out the airlines become more customer-driven. And he used the term to mean those moments in which there were any opportunity for the organization to make a difference while interacting with the customer. And since that time, there has been an unending push to find more and better ways to connect with the customers and track those interactions. In fact, the explosive growth of customer relationship management has created a multi-billion dollar IT and consulting services business focused on just this issue. But you know what, these technology-based solutions may cause organizations to lose sight of the core issue which drives the customer relationship. And this is precisely where the moment of truth, touch points, and customer experience intersect. The moment of truth is an opportunity for an organization to make an impression on a customer or any of the stakeholders. The touch points are actually the static human and interactive interactions that actually create these impressions. And working together, touch points create positive or negative impressions at any given moment of truth. And what is the result? Customer experience. Customer experience as perceived by the customer, which is the only perspective that actually counts. Now, in terms of customer experience, touch points are more than just transactional moments. They're critical interactions within the customer journey that actually help define key moments in the process, which can build or erode customer trust. But customer trust points are often misunderstood for what they really are. So customer touch points are actually not just a business jargon. It goes much, much beyond business jargon. They're meaningful only when the organization or the brands understand them at the core. Understanding your customer's current situation and what drives them towards loyalty or defection. These are two extremes, but you need to understand what actually drives them. And it is the very first step in delivering a superior customer experience. Now, understanding actual touch points your customers have with you. It's the basic part of organization. And customer touch points at any point of interaction with a brand across three main phases of customer life cycle. That is, it starts from awareness, it goes to evaluation, and it prolongs till post-purchase phase. And it has a great impact on the way customers perceive your product and service and leads to an overall customer experience. So identifying your customer journey touch points is the first and the foremost step to create a map, which will help businesses to identify the touch points in phases and manage customer experience to deliver a great experience overall. Now I'd like to take you through a quick slide on moments of truth, which customers undergo throughout his journey. My screen is visible, Raj Rajeshwari?
No, I was not visible.
Okay, just a second. Is that visible now?
No, ma'am. It's visible, ma'am.
Is it visible? Thank you. Okay, so this is a quick capture of what the moment of truth stands for. If you can see, there isn't stimulus, an external stimulus, which leads to a zero moment of truth. Zero moment of truth refers to all the interactions which happen online. A customer has a need and then he searches for your product or service or anything online. So that's the zero moment of truth. The first moment of truth is when actually he visits your store or a physical layout, and there second moment of truth when the customer actually starts using your product or service and develops a kind of perception based on his expectation and what kind of product or services has been delivered. And the ultimate moment of truth, which counts a lot, that is based on his experience in the second moment of truth, whether he would like to further recommend your brand to other people in a positive way or a negative way. Happy. Definitely, if you have delivered a wow experience, he'll definitely refer your brand in a positive way to many people, and that counts a lot. And by chance, if your brand has done a mistake or is not, your brand has not been able to meet the expectations of the customers, he'll have a negative experience. And if you're not able to cater to his dissatisfaction, he'll be the person who will create a mess for you, because he'll be creating a bad word of mouth for you. And you can imagine one bad word of mouth on social media can create a havoc for you. So it's important for the brands to understand each and every moment of truth and ensure that customer has a positive experience while interacting with your brand at any point of time, whether it's your website, whether it's your store, whether it's a post-purchase query, whether it's a while usage query or any interaction, they need to have an exceptionally good customer experience. So moving ahead, let me just stop share. Is the screen still visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Is the presentation still visible or it's closed down?
It's visible, ma'am.
With that, you try to understand the various moments of truth which a customer undergoes throughout his life cycle. Now, assessing the customer experience is one very important thing. Experience can look like a subjective concept that's difficult to be measured. And that's when the brand needs to rely on a number of different customer experience metrics that can be used individually or together to get an indication of what exactly customer feels about your brand or about the customer experience in your business. Let me share the matrix with you. Can you see the screen?
No, ma'am.
Seems it's some issue with my PowerPoint. No worries. So there are various metrics. We'll just talk about two or three major metrics. Now, by having a measurable indicator of customer experience. You can track how it improves or worsens over time. Use it to evaluate the success or failure of the changes you make that might be affecting your customers. So the few prominent metrics, one of them is customer effort score. Now, customer effort score talks about the experience or it measures the experience with a product or service in terms of how difficult or easy was it for the customer to complete a particular action or a particular interaction with your brand. Customer effort score surveys are usually sent out after an interaction with customer service with the questions like how easy was it to get your issue resolved today, and rating the scale from maybe 1 is very difficult to 5 to very easy. So they also work well after the scores, the customers reach important milestones in their journey, like after they sign up for a free product trial or after they have successfully completed a transaction. Another prominent metric is Net Promoter Score. Now, Net Promoter Score is a customer loyalty score that is derived from asking customers a simple closed-ended question. Like on a scale of 1 to 10 or 0 to 10, how likely are you to recommend this product or service to your friend or your colleague? You can choose to adapt the questions slightly to better suit to your business requirements and use the follow-up NPS questions to get more insights. But the point of NPS is to get a simple numerical score on a scale of 0 to 100 that represents customer experience as a whole, and based on experience, whether you would like to really be your brand advocate, whether you would like to recommend your product or service to another person. The third prominent metric is customer satisfaction score. We call it CSAT. It measures customer satisfaction with the product or service they receive from you. It can be expressed with a 5-pointer scale or even a 7-pointer scale. Like the Net Promoter Score, which asks customers to consider their overall feeling towards the brand and thus the likelihood of recommending. CSAT focuses the customer's attention on specific touch points they were satisfied or dissatisfied with. So that is like you get a kind of an analytical data on the productivity or effectiveness of each of the touch points. And last but not the least, there is one matrix called time to resolution, TTR. It's average length of time it takes customers, team to resolve an issue or tickets after it has been opened by a customer, right? So it can be a measure, can be measured in terms of days or number of business hours, and is calculated by adding up all the times to resolution and dividing the time by the total number of cases resolved. And it's indeed a very crucial metric to track and improve. The shorter your TTR is, the higher the chances your customer will not experience frustration when they reach out for help, which is very, very important. Now, sometimes what happens, brands have a myopic view of dealing with customer satisfaction and loyalty. It is assumed that all satisfied customers are going to be your loyal customers, which actually is not true. And assuming that might be the biggest mistake a brand could make. A customer may be with you for a longer time, despite of the fact he's not satisfied with you. Or a customer can be satisfied, but there are still chances that he'll switch over to another brand or the product or service. So it's important that you segregate your customers based on the level of satisfaction and loyalty they are portraying. There's a very famous and a popular model, which is called Postel's model, which talks about satisfaction and loyalty. Let me see if I can just show you that model. It's a very interesting way to segregate your customers. Let me try and open up my presentation again. Uh, Is the screen visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, great. So you can have a look at the Apostles model. Apostles model has satisfaction on one axis and loyalty on one axis. And it measures both the things from a scale of low, medium, and it reaches to high. Now, if you just have a close look, people who are high on satisfaction and people who are high on loyalty, they are called loyalists. Loyalists are people who would stay with you forever. The expectation what they had with the brand, probably that has been met, and that's the reason they are satisfied with your brand. And if you deal with this category of people with some extra care, if you're able to delight them, if you're able to provide a wow factor to these people, they'll turn into your apostles. Apostles are people who would be your brand advocates. They would talk positive about the brand. They'll ensure that they'll get a good number of leads and prospects with your brand. So it's important that you try to nurture the loyalist and turn them into apostles. The other category is the hostages. Hostages are people who are, if you just have a look, it's, they are high on loyalty, but they are not satisfied with you. This is a typical situation. Reason being, these are people, they're staying with you. You think as a brand, if you think that they are staying with you and they are satisfied, that's the biggest mistake, because they are with you just for a reason. Maybe as the name suggests, hostage is somebody who's with you, is a captive due to some reason. Maybe there are switching barriers or you have the monopoly as of now. But as soon as a person gets a chance, the customer gets a chance to leave your brand, he would definitely leave your brand. So you have to be very careful with such people, and you have to be constantly in touch with such people and understand their concerns, why they're not satisfied with your brand. Looking at another category are the biggest chunk, that is mercenaries. If you have a look at it, mercenaries are people who are highly satisfied with your brand. Despite of the fact they're satisfied, they're not loyal with your brand. These are the people who are the biggest chunk, and these are the people, these are the customers who will switch to the competitors as soon as they can get a better offer from them. So these are the people whom you cannot really give any wow factors and retain them. But then you can maximize the sales with these people as and when they are with you. And the last category, which is the most crucial category, is defectors. Defectors are people, you can just have a look at the lowest grid that says they are low on satisfaction and they are low on loyalty as well. So that's a category of customers who needs to be dealt with a priority. Reason being, they are not satisfied with you. That means they have some expectations and your brand is not able to fulfill those expectations. And they are also willing to switch over. They don't want to be loyal with you. And in case if they have some serious concerns which your brand ignores or doesn't take care of, they're not addressed, they'll turn into terrorists. What does terrorist means here? Terrorists are people or the customers who will opt out of your brand. That is one thing. And the more dangerous thing is, they would be the people who will go for a negative word of mouth for you. As I said earlier, one negative word of mouth on a social media can create a havoc for your brand. So you have to be very careful in dealing with people whom you feel they are not satisfied, they've expressed their concerns. So customer complaints is something which should be dealt with very seriously. Customer complaint should not be taken negatively. That's my personal feeling is, a customer complaint should be taken positively. In the sense, it's an opportunity for your brand to retain that customer. If the customer has really expressed his complaint or a concern, that means he still look forward to staying with your brand. So it's up to your brand to take care of his concern, his complaints, and try and understand him. And that's the time, if you're able to solve his complaint, he'll be with you forever. So this is all about Apostles model. And a postal model is something which is very interesting, and it's a very popular way wherein the brands really find out how a customer can be segregated, the customers can be segregated, and each segment of customer, each quadrant of customer, whether it's a postal, whether it's a defector, whether it's a mercenary or a hostage, they need to have a different strategy to be dealt with. Once you have a different strategy for each set of customer, definitely your customer experience management would be on a great heights. So with this, we come to the conclusion of this session. What I would like to say is you should focus on mapping customer journeys and leverage them in the right way in order to deliver consistent customer experience. The brand should try and create an emotional connect with the customers at various moments of truth. And that emotional connect plays a very crucial role. It gets entwined in their DNA. Remember, a product or a service can easily be imitated, but an experience can never be imitated. Have your own points of differentiations to cater to an experience which will be for life for them, for focusing on creating some wow moments for your customers and try and occupy a place in their heart. So that's all from my end. I hope I'm able to give some insights into what customer experiences and why customer experience management is something which brands should really focus on, and why, what is the importance of customer experience in your life, as your, whether it's a corporate journey you start with or an entrepreneurial journey you start with, you have to deal with the customers at each point of time. You'll be dealing with the customers day in and day out. So it's very crucial that you understand the importance of each and every customer. You know how you prioritize your interactions with the customers. You should know how you should segregate your customers, and you should have a strategy for all the customers who are belong to any of the categories or any of the segments. Each segment is important, each customer is important, and each customer is different. So give them a differentiated experience, give them a wow experience, and your brand can be on the top. Thank you so much. I would be open to questions if there are any. I'd love to take questions.
Dr. Pallavi?
Yes, sir.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Yeah. Hello, madam. Yeah. Ma'am, my question is like, how can we go with the emotional connect with the customer? And like, as customers are very fickle-minded in nature, right? So we can't, yeah. And but at the same time, like, how we can go? Because even though like trying so much, but still, I mean, making them loyal with, suppose, our own brand, how can we go with it? Please suggest.
So much for your question. It's indeed, that's the crux of customer relationship management. Indeed, it's a time, the one point of time there was, the brands had a monopoly. You didn't have to focus so much on retaining the customer, because customer was your customer. If they have a need, they are your customers. But today it's an era of hyper-competitiveness, and each brand has been developing all sort of products and services to for the customers. So it's actually difficult to deliver something exceptional to the customer. But as you just said, that customer has to be connected with you emotionally. So emotional connection is created when you are able to utilize the customer data to engage those customers on a constant basis. You need to, like, if there's no dearth of data. Customer data, a CRM is something which is completely based on customer data. So utilizing that customer data, utilizing that data to develop some kind of customer insights and analytics, and then based on your understanding of that customer, you try to reach out to the customer, you try to constantly engage the customers, you try to reach out to them proactively. it's not, you should not wait for a complaint to happen, or if he is not coming back to you, you assume that he's a satisfied customer. Like we just saw in the Apostles model, that if the customer is not coming back to you, you should not assume that he is satisfied or he'll stay with you for long. So it's something you need to connect with the customers, you need to engage with the customer and create a emotional connect with the customer. And that's the time you kind of surpass their expectation. Every brand will try to maintain the expectations and deliver in those lines. But you need to go beyond the expectations. And you can go beyond the expectations only when you know your customers very well. So know the customers and try to create an emotional connect with them. And that's the time, that's something which a competitor cannot really imitate. You can definitely imitate the product, you can imitate the service. Very often it happens that your point of differentiation become point of similarity in the market very soon. But that experience cannot be really imitated. And experience comes only when you are able to create a connect. And the connection comes when you are able to make use of the customer data and convert it into insights and deliver something which really the customer wants.
Great. So sincere thanks to you for explaining such a, this question.
Pleasure. I hope I'm able to answer your query.
Definitely. And sincere thanks to Aircruise Aviation also. They have organized such a wonderful session. So thank you so much. This is Dr. Subrata Day from Symbiosis University. Thank you.
Great, Dr. Day. Thank you so much for your query and thank you so much for your presence. I'd like to have another questions if somebody has any questions.
Ma'am?
Yes, Rajeshwari.
Ma'am, if we are having starting a brand tools in the market, so that time we have to get a customer views that what their opinions regarding our product. So how many time that we can get an opinion by forms or something other ways, that what is a better way to get the experience, better way to get the opinion that how the product is appeared in a product in the brand in the market?
Okay, you're talking about before you launch a product in the market, is it?
No, ma'am, after launching the product, how the product status in the market, how we can get the review of the product.
Definitely, Radha Rajeshwari, that was my point, what I just answered to Dr. Day as well, that once you are launching your product or once your customers have used your product or a service, it's you have the customer data, right? You know your customer, you have the customer data. So it's up to you how you reach out to your customers, how you take their feedback, how you go out of the way to help them to use the product or service. Or there's a concept called post-purchase dissonance. So many times customers have that thing as well in their mind. So you need to cater to that feeling as well. So it's up to a brand to create that reassurance in the mind of the customers that, yes, you've taken a right decision and we are here to help you out. And you need to ask them about their opinion of how much they are finding the product or the services in line with the expectation they had with the brands. So you need to assess whether you were able to meet their expectations or not, whether you were beyond the expectations, that is to be assessed by your brand. So you may go for a survey, you may go for personal calling. It depends on from brand to brand and product to product. But yeah, definitely, after your customer has gone for purchase decision, he's using your product service, definitely you should constantly try to create an engagement with your customer and try to create a reassurance in the minds of the customers that they've made a right decision. I hope I'm able to answer your query, Rajeshwari.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Pleasure. Any other questions? I'd like love to take the questions. Okay. I think we can wrap up the session. It was a pleasure addressing you all. And I would again like to thank Captain Shekhar for this wonderful series of webinars for these youngsters. And I am told that these sessions are recorded and they're shared with the students on a large scale. So that's really good. people are benefited and you have taken this initiative. So a lot of congratulations and all the best. So over to you, Captain.
Raja Rajeshwari.
Yes, sir.
Up to you now.
Okay, sir. We often take for granted the very thing that most deserve our gratitude. We would like to propose a hearty vote of thanks to you, Dr. Pallavi Joshi Kapurai, for gracing today's webinar and delivering the important topic on navigating customer experience. I'm sure that all the participants have taken notes of your suggestion and will initiate that further in their career. Lastly, we thank again on the behalf of our whole Aircrew Aviation Private Limited team. Thank you so much, ma'am, for an amazing session.
Thank you so much. Thank you. And have a nice day.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much.